Rakuoka, you are wadi olo, you are wadi, you are wadi olo, Maliga Sudayaba, you are wadi olo, invisible God, Mirakuoka, you are wadi olo, you are wadi lo, 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 Israel of this, you are wadi lo, the rose of Sharon, you are wadi lo, you are wadi lo, you are wadi lo, Maria Gasudayama. You are worthy, Lord, Maliga Adasidalaba. You are worthy, Lord, Makurimu Sinibi. You are worthy, Lord. Father, we worship you, Lord. You are worthy, King of Kings. You are Lord, the Lord of Lords. You are worthy, Ancient of Days. You are worthy, the Rose of Sharon. We thank you for yesterday. We thank you for what you are going to do today. Father, as we go into your word and prayer, Holy Spirit of God, help me love this service. Power of the Most High God, help me love this service. Counsel of God, help me love this service. Fire of God, help me love this service. I commit, O Lord, your hearer unto you, Lord. They will not just be here, you make them dwell the world. Father, Lord, speak through me. Let me not speak any word of my home, but let me serve on the throne of grace. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, man. Good morning. Good evening. Wherever you are, the part of the world, you are welcome to the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Jesus House, Kololo, Kampala, Uganda, where God is helping us to raise great people to transform their world by the word of God. Let us pray. You are glorious. You are glorious. You are glorious to be praised. You are glorious. You are glorious. You are glorious to be praised. I want you to cry to God. Say, my Father, my Father, my Savior, in this situation, glorify yourself in my life. Glorify yourself in my business. Glorify yourself in my career. Let's lift our voice and cry to the heaven. My Father, my Father, my Savior, as we gather here this afternoon, Father, glorify yourself in this service. Glorify yourself in our life. Glorify yourself in our career. Glorify yourself in our trade. Glorify yourself in our business. Kali atu segede, ele kete kete, zebre tu zaga, zebre tu ga, lidas kedege, leta kataya, edaliga tusa, ataliga. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. I'd like us to cry out. I cry to God this afternoon because coronavirus is a setup. It's a setup for a lifting up. It's a setup. It came in as a flaw. But the word of God made us to realize when the enemies have come to us like a flaw, it will lift up the standard of Jesus again. We want to cry to God this evening afternoon. He said, my Father, my Father, my Savior, every setup or every demonic setup against my life, against my business, against my ministry, against my career, Father, turn them to a lifting up. Father, turn them to a lifting up. Father, turn them to a lifting up. In the name of Jesus. My Father, my Father, my Savior, every setup by pandemic, called coronavirus, against our lifting up. Father, turn it to a lifting up. A setup by against our business. A setup against our career. A setup again, turn it to a lifting up. In the name of Jesus. Turn it to a lifting up. In Jesus' name we pray. I like God to give up, lift our voice to them. The Bible says, only the living can praise him. I like to say, Father, I thank you. I'm still counting among the living today. Isaiah 38:19. Say, Father, I thank you. I'm still counting among the living. I thank you for the gift of life. I thank you for my business. I thank you for my career. I thank you for my trade. I thank you for my occupation. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you for our business, for our career, for our occupation. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Leba tu za guli gazada za liga tezke lege zetuli galiga zada lege entaliga. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name, I want us to cry to the heaven this afternoon and call on the God of Abraham and God of Isaac and God of Israel. Say, my Father, my concern me. The Bible, the word of God say in Isaiah chapter 1 verse 19, say to the righteous, it shall be well with him. He shall eat the good of the land. Say, my father, let it be well with me. As a righteous, let it be well with me. In this pandemic situation, let it be well with my business. Let it be well with my career. Let it be well with me. Let it be well with me. In Isaiah 3:10, he says, say to the righteous, it shall be well with him, and he shall eat the good fruit of his doing. Say to the righteous, Isaiah 3:10, say, my father, in this season, as your child, let it be well with me, in Jesus' name. As written in your word, in Isaiah 3:10, let it be well with me. Let me eat the fruit of my doing. Let it be well with me, in Jesus' name. Let it be well with my business. Let it be well with my career. Let it be well with our finances. Let us eat the good of our doings. In the name of Jesus, Libra to Zagada, Litusa to Kalawa. In Jesus' name we pray. In the same Isaiah chapter 3, verse 11, he says, on the other way, when you are not righteous, it shall be healed with him. He says, say to the wicked, it shall be healed with him. We are going to cry to God, say, Father, every wicked activity, every satanic activity against my business, against my career, let it be healed with them, Lord. As it's written, oh, let it be healed with them. Let it be healed, oh Lord. Let it be healed with them. Say, woe unto the wicked, it shall be healed with them. Father, every wicked activity, every evil activity against our business, against our home, against our children, let it be healed with them in Jesus' name. Let it be healed with them in Jesus' name. He said, woe unto the wicked, every wicked activity going on in your environment, going on in your business, going on in the life of your children. Let the word of God say, woe unto them. He said, be destroyed. Let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. Every wicked personality, every wicked oppression against our life, against our business, be destroyed in Jesus' name. Be destroyed in Jesus' name. Sheba la kuta liga daga. Zebra to zega laga. Zabra to zege. Ele to skede. Zebra to zaga adege. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, it is normal that in this kind of season of coronavirus, some people will take advantage of this season and will perpetrate the wickedness. Some people will take advantage of this season to perpetrate wickedness. And the word of God makes us realize in Psalm 7, verse 11, he said, God judge the righteous, and God is angry with the wicked. And every day, you are going to cry to God, say, Father, any human being that is exploiting this situation to bring in wickedness against our children of God, Father, let your wrath of judgment be upon them. Let your wrath of judgment be upon them in the name of Jesus, that it will stand upon your wall. In Psalm 7, verse 11, it says, God judge the righteous, but God is angry with the wicked. Every day, every human being, every gang of human being that is exploiting this situation to perpetrate evil in our homes, in our lives, in our businesses, in our career. Father, let your wrath of judgment be visited upon them. Every day, let your wrath of judgment be visited upon them. Every day, in Jesus' name, Zeba Libra to Zaga, Zebre to Segede, Letu Galia Tuga, Zabra to Leka. In Jesus' name we pray. As I said, he said in this season, many people will be exploiting this situation to cause evil, to cause this destruction, to cause even bad things to people. The word of God said in Psalm 7 verse 10, he said, my God, my defense is God, which saved the upright in heart. My defense is of God. My defense is of God. We save the upright in the heart. You are going to cry to God. You are there in your office, in your vocation, in your trade. People want to be in this situation of coronavirus, of this lockdown, to use it against you. They want to set it up against you. This is the word of God for you. Either in your office, somebody who hates you before is collating your name as people to be sacked or people to reduce their salary. We're going to use this scripture to pray. Maybe in your training environment, somebody wants to use this opportunity to make sure that he deny you of sin or to scheme you out. We are going to use this scripture to pray. Say, Father, as your child, please defend me. Defend my business. Defend my ministry. Defend everything that concerns in this season. Defend everything that concerns us. Defend our business. Defend our career from every form of destruction, from every form of stealing, from every form of killing. Father, destroy our business. Father, defend our business. Defend our career. Defend our ministry. Defend everything that concerns us in this season. Every exploitation that wants to be used against us by the principality and power, by the ruler of darkness, by the cabal. Father, defend us in Jesus' name. Defend us in Jesus' name. Defend us in Jesus' name. Defend our business. Defend our finance. Defend our children. Defend our ministry. Defend our career. Father, defend us. Savior, defend us. Lema to Zapolege. Zebre to Sekete. Likutaliga. Ada Yaka Dada. Zebre to say. Defend everything that concerns us. In this season, Lord, defend us. Defend everything that concerns us. Defend everything that concerns us. Shakata Laka. And the two Zege. Le to Zadada. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. In Psalm number 7, verse 13. Because the wicked is very stubborn. He said, in Psalm number 7, verse 13. He said, God has prepared for him the instrument of death. He ordained his hour against the persecutors. You are going to cry to heaven this evening, this afternoon. Say, Father, every persecutor of my business, of my marriage, of my home, of my finances, of everything that concerns me in this season, ordain arrow of destruction against them. Ordain arrow of destruction against them. My Father, my Savior, my King and my Lord, every persecutor of my glory, every persecutor of your glory, every persecutor of everything that concerns you in this season, my God, my Savior, Father, ordain arrow, an instrument of destruction against them, Jesus. Ordain arrow, an instrument of destruction against them, Jesus. Libra segedo, litus abrasege, zebro tu zegede, litus galiga, latoje galaga, bale dos dalaba, bale gatus gedege, leta kuda rotoko. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to cry to the heaven. The word of God made us clear. He made it also realize. He's in Isaiah 43. He said, we do a new thing. Verse 19. He said, we make a way where there is no way. And we make a river in desert. We are going to cry to God. Say, Father, in this season, when they say there is no way, there is no business, Father, make a way for me. When men are saying there is a casting down, Father, let there be a lifting up for me. Let there be a lifting up for every life concerning me. Lift up and say, Father, in this season, make a way for us. When they say there is no way, make a way for us. You are the way maker. You are the miracle worker. Father, create a miracle for us in our business, in our homes, in our career. Create a way for us. Lebra sudayaba, letu sakuda, ada legedo, letu skadegede. Father, make a way for us, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. At this junction, there are some people here the Lord want us to pray about. Lord, want me to, there's particular person under the sound of my voice, and I was praying for this service. The Lord told me that somebody under the sound of this voice this afternoon, you have a blister all around your body. There is a blister all around your body. He said there are two categories. Somebody had a physical blister all around his body. Another one, he could not see that blister, but you can see something like that, imaginary. I pray for you this afternoon that the Lord will heal every demonic blister on your body, every discomfort in your body, everything that's making you discomfort in form of demonic blister, the Lord will heal you in Jesus' name. Jesus will set you free. The Lord will heal you in Jesus' name. And the Lord will set you free of every invisible demonic blister in your body in the name of Jesus. That God will take away discomfort in the name of Jesus. My Father will take away discomfort in your body in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. God is dealing with skin issue today. God is dealing with this. I hear again that there's somebody whose skin is peeling off. You are not an old person, but your skin is peeling off. It's just peeling off. Lebra suda yaga. Le tuza bote kede. Le dasko. Father, pray for concerning that your daughter, that your child, oh Lord, that you have a skin that is peeling off. From nowhere, the skin that is peeling off, they cannot be explained. My Father, my God, I pray for any power being upon the person. And the Lord says, I should declare upon your life that I will give you a brand new skin, like a new baby, like is happened for to General Neymar in 2 Kings chapter 5. That God said he will give you a baby skin in the name of Jesus. And all the peeling will stop in the name of Jesus. All the peeling will stop in the name of Jesus. And the Lord wants me to tell you that for that person, you need to do a water baptism. You need to do a water baptism. I don't know who you are, but God said you must do a water baptism to cleanse you permanently in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Thank you. I want God to lift our voice and cry to God this afternoon and talk to God concerning our children. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, it is written in your word. In Psalm 127, verse 3, he said, children are the heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of what they are. Father, we pray concerning our children. Make them indeed an heritage. Heritage of joy, heritage of blessing, heritage of signs and wonder. Father, make our children heritage of blessing, heritage of joy, heritage of signs and wonder. Father, this is the have mercy on us. Make our children heritage of joy, heritage of blessing, heritage of signs and wonder. Devil will not make use of our children in the name of Jesus. They will not make use of our children in the name of Jesus. Le bra tu zabo, le duz ge liga tu za, va liga da le moske le mo, za bra tu sege, e liga das kadaga, za bre tu saga, le kuda liga, za bre tu shega laga, ada yaga. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. We want to pray one prayer, another prayer point for those people who are trusting God for the fruit of wombs. We are going to cry to God and tell God, say, Father, in the name of Jesus, if you give me a child, I will lend you no child. Just like Anna said, Father, if you want a child, say, Father, if you give me a child, I will lend you to you. Just like Anna did. Father, I pray for all these women who are trusting you for the fruit of womb. My God and my Savior, you will give them a child. You will give them children, O Lord, so that they can lend them to you in the name of Jesus. Zebra tu zaku, le dadi botus kalege, zebra tu skadaga, let there be an overflow. Overflow of children now. Overflow of power. Overflow of anointing. I command open heaven over this service. Every restriction, every limitation, broken in the name of Jesus. I command open heaven. Open heaven. Open heaven over every viewers under the watch right now. The heaven open over you. The heaven of abundance. The heaven of glory. The heaven of power. There shall be no limitation. There shall be no restriction over your life, over your business, over your destiny, over your career, over your home, over your marriage. In the name, restriction is removed in the name of Jesus. I say restriction is removed in the name of Jesus. I say embargo is lifted in the name of Jesus. I say embargo is lifted in the name of Jesus. I say restriction is removed in the name of Jesus. Delay is over. Delay is over. Delay conception is over. Delay conception is over in the name of Jesus. Delay conception is over in the name of Jesus. The lay concern is over in the name of Jesus. The lay concern is over in the name of Jesus. Because your parents give back to you, you will give back to somebody. Somebody glorious, somebody great, somebody that will be a vessel of God in the name of Jesus. Every delay concern, it is over. Every blockage in the womb, it is removed. Every blockage in the womb is removed in Jesus' name. Every blockage in the womb is removed. Lay kasakata, ege, blockade is removed. To thank you, Jesus. Every fallopian tube blockade is removed in Jesus' name. Every fallopian tube blockade, it is removed. It is removed. It is removed in the name of Jesus. Shaka tolege. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. At this season, we want to pray for those who are businessmen, the corporate people, the employees and employers. You are going to cry to God. Say, Father, in this season, you will take me from glory to glory in my business, in my career. I will not know limitation. There shall be no demotion. Father, I pray for every of your children under the sound of my voice. This afternoon, there shall be no restriction in their business. There shall be no limitation in their business. You will take them from scarcity to abundance. You will take them from scarcity to abundance in this season, in the name of Jesus. Father, you will help them in this season, in the name of Jesus. Seble kutige ele kushalaba andayaga. In Jesus' name we pray. We are still praying for ourselves, for business people, traders, professionals. We are still praying. In this season, you need the help of God. You need to walk in supernatural to receive the great, the miraculous. You need to walk in the supernatural to receive the miraculous. You are going to cry to God. The God, you are going to cry to God this afternoon. If that is reading the word of God, the word of God said to us in John 14:26, he said the Holy Spirit will teach us all things. He will teach us all things. And he will guide us to all things. So you are going to cry to God. Say, Father, from this season, I want to dwell in the Holy Spirit. Let my business be working supernatural. Let my career be working supernatural so that we can receive the miraculous. Father, let every businesses, every trade, every career, every organization that is under the sound of my voice this afternoon, let them begin to receive the impartation of the Holy Spirit to walk in the supernatural so that they can receive the miraculous. To walk in supernatural to receive the miraculous. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, shout a yegede, let the kede, let us again, let the ladder, let to say gede, let gadus calabar. In Jesus' name we pray. In this is in Sama. If you are the boss, is discouraged, and your energy is deflated, there is no way you can encourage your people. So you are going to cry to God. Because the word of God says in 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 6 to 8, the word of God says, when there was a problem, when David had a lockdown, that all his children, all his wives and the children of his army were taken away. They wanted to stone him. But the Bible says David encouraged himself in the Lord. Say, Father, in this season, let me be encouraged by your word. Let me be encouraged by your word. Holy Spirit, encourage me this season so that I can encourage my people. Holy Spirit, encourage me this season so that I can encourage my people. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray in this season, Holy Spirit of God, you encourage your people. You encourage the leaders. You encourage leaders so that they can encourage their people. Let them receive strength in this season. Let them receive strength in this divine strength for encouragement. Divine strength so that they can make greater productivity. In the name of Jesus, let them receive divine strength in the midst of calamity and COVID-19. Let them receive divine strength. Encourage them, O Lord, in Jesus' name. The word of God said, David encourage himself in the Lord. Father, these people as they study the word of God, encourage them as they pray, encourage them as leaders so that they can encourage their people in the name of Jesus. In this season, they will not be weary because you said in your word in Proverbs 24, verse 10, you said you fail in the day of adversity. Your strength is small. Your people will not fail in this season. We will not fail in this season. Our business will not fail in this season. Your career will not fail in this season. Your home will not fail in this season. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Few more prayer points before as we go into the war. And this season we are going to pray for homes. We're going to pray for homes. Because homes will be a major attack of all this COVID-19. Because of no money, husband and wife might be fighting, you might fight, money made to fight, landlord and tenant and all those things. We are going to cry to God. Say, Father, in this season, because Joshua said, as for me and my family, we serve the Lord. Say, Father, in this season, you will protect families. You will protect homes in Jesus' name. There shall not be disaster in home. There will be unity in the homes, in all over our nations, in the name of Jesus. That is, preserve home this season. Preserve family this season. Preserve home this season. Preserve family this season. Let there be no calamity. Let there be no destruction. Let there be no fight between husband and wife. Let there be no quarrel that will scatter the home. In the name of Jesus, let your people walk in love. Let the family walk in love. Let the home walk in unity. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray. Moving from scarcity to abundance. Moving from scarcity from abundance. If you look at the story of the four lepers in 2 Kings 7, 2 Kings 7 from verse 3 to 10. Moving from scarcity to abundance. 2 Kings chapter 7. 2 Kings chapter 7. verse 3 to 10. One clear thing that was noticeable in that story is that the leper took a decision, a constructive and favorable decision. They do not took a constructive decision, a constructive and godly decision. A consulting and godly decision. A consulting, we are going to cry to God. Decision at this season need to be very careful. There are decisions you will take, this you will take it to the next level. There are decisions somebody will take, this you will take them back up. So you are going to cry and say, Father, help families, help home to take a godly and constructive decision this season. Father, help family, help homes to take a godly and constructive decision this season. Decision that will move them forward. Decision that will take the family forward. Decision that will take business forward. Decision that will take career forward. Let them to take that decision. In the name of Jesus. Je badidoska retuza guda lida kushke letuza daba letuze gede retuze gedege lebra tuza baligata. Decision that will take ministry to forward. Let them to take it this season. Decision that will take ministry forward. Let them to take it this season. In the name of Jesus. Leketuza bra. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. You are worthy, O Lord. You are worthy, O Lord. Invisible God. You are the miracle worker. You are worthy, O Lord. You are worthy. You are worthy, O Lord. Malia Tugazegede. You are worthy, O Lord, Mahalegede, invisible God, a miracle worker. You are worthy, O Lord. Leko Sidaba, and God also pray. Say, Father, in this season, you are the invisible God. Make yourself, O Lord, a visible God in my life. Let them see your glory in my life. Say, my Father, my Savior, you are the invisible God. You are the almighty God in this season. Show yourself mightily in my home. Show yourself mightily in my business. Show yourself mightily in our career. Show yourself mightily in everything that concerns you. Father, let them see your glory. Let them see your might. Let them see your counsel. Let them see your blessing in our life, in our home, in this season. In the name of Jesus. Le bretuzeba, le duske liga, hata lige. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, we just want to thank you this season. We want to thank you this afternoon for another time to gather in your presence. As we go into your word, Father, in the name of Jesus, speak to us, O Lord. Let no man be hard. Let Jesus be glorified. Father, I yield myself unto you, Lord. Let your word come with power. Let it come with fire. In Jesus' name we pray. 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 This afternoon we are talking about set up for a lift up. 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 And we are taking our scripture from the book of Daniel chapter 5. Daniel chapter 6, verse 5 to 10. 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 And the word of God said, then the president, the prince sought to find occasion against Daniel concerning the kingdom of God, but they could find no occasion for. For as much he has faithful, he was faithful, neither was there any error or fault found in him. I speak to somebody in this season. No error will be found in you in Jesus' name. No man will find any fault in you in Jesus' name. Then send this man. We shall not find any occasion against this Daniel, except we find it against concerning the law of his God. Then this president and the princes assembled together to the king and said thus to him, the king Darius, live forever. All the president of the kingdom, the governor and the princes, the counselor and the captain have consulted together to establish a royal statute to make a firm decree that whosoever shall ask the petition of any god or man for 30 days, save of thee, O king, he shall be cast into the dens of lion. Now, O king, establish the decree, sign the writing that is not changed according to the law of the Medes and Persian, which alter not. Wherefore, King Darius signed the writing and the decree. Now, when David knew that the writing was signed, he went into the house, and his window being open in the chamber toward Jerusalem, he kneeled down upon his knees 3 times a day. He kneeled and prayed and gave thanks to his God and lived after time. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Now, set up for a lift up. Set up for a lift up. This is a story of Daniel and two other prince presidents who have been appointed by King Darius to administer the land. And the word of God said in the second Daniel chapter 6 verse 3, Daniel 6 verse 3, he said Daniel was far more capable to order. So therefore, Daniel was made the king of the, was made the leader of all the presidents. And these people said, what are we going to do? They set him up. So what is a setup? Set up is a demonic scheme. Is a demonic scheme. Is a demonic scheme and cheat orchestrated from the kingdom of darkness to incriminate somebody, to deceive somebody. Is a framework, is a conspiracy to put someone into a disadvantage, to demote somebody, eventually kill that person, eventually kill the business, eventually kill the career, eventually kill the ministry. I speak to someone today. Every setup from the corpus of hell to kill your business, to kill your career, in this season of COVID-19, the Lord will turn them to a lifter for you. The Lord will turn them to a lifter for you. In the name of Jesus, there can be set up in an organization. There is scheming organization to make sure the best candidate for a position is denied or scheme out. There is somebody on this now, right now, there is something is going up in your office to appoint somebody to be in charge of a very important position. And somebody, some people are guarding up and scheming against you. In the name that's above every name, in the name of Jesus, that scheme will be scattered in Jesus' name. It is scattered in the name of Jesus. Daniel was a case study in this matter. Daniel was set up because he had been appointed the leader of everybody and he's a foreigner. He was set up so that he will be denied of that position already that he has gotten there. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody, thank you, Holy Spirit. Somebody just step into a new shoe now. You just got a new position. And this setup is about to come upon to you. Some people are gathering together now. They are coming up with a scheme to say, why should it be this guy? We will make him to fail. The Lord says, I should tell you, because promotion comes neither from this of the word of the south, but from the Almighty God. Because they never promoted you, they cannot bring you down, Jesus' name. The Lord says, I should tell you, they never promoted you, and they will not bring you down. And they cannot bring you down in the name of Jesus. What is a setup? Setup is a long-term sickness. Setup can be a long-term sickness, a long-term disease to ensure that someone does not fulfill God's ordained destiny. A setup can be a demonic sickness perpetrated, infiltrated, designed from the kingdom of darkness to make sure somebody does not fulfill his ordained destiny. I pray for as many people today that the enemy is giving you terminal sickness of cancer, diabetes, so that you not fulfill the original mandate of God for your life. That setup is going to be canceled and you'll be lifted up in Jesus' name. The man at the beautiful gate was a case study in Acts chapter 3, verse 1 to 10. Acts chapter 3, verse 1 to 10. That man is a man of the lame at beautiful gate. The Bible said this man was lame from his mother's womb. It wasn't that he was born lame. It wasn't that he has lameness along the line. Right from the womb, he was born lame. Because why? The devil knew he's going to be a praise worship leader. A mighty praise worship leader. So he made sure someone that's supposed to be inside the church is outside the church and a beggar. Someone that's supposed to be praising God inside the church is outside the church begging. I pray for anybody here. The enemy has manipulated their destiny through terminal sickness, through terminal disease. I said the healing power of God is rest upon you today, Justin. The healing power of God is rest upon you today. You are healed in the name of Jesus. Setup can be a demonic attack. A demonic attack again to inflict someone with sicknesses, disease, with the objective to make sure the finances of that person is down. Somebody can be set up from the kingdom of darkness, from the covens of hell, to make sure somebody is attacked. is afflicted with a terminal disease, incurable disease, such with the objective to measure all the money he or she has invested or got in his life is went down the drain. The idea is not to make sure the person become pauper. In Mark chapter 5, verse 25 to 34. Mark chapter 5, verse 25, there was a story of a woman come there, the woman with issue of blood. The Bible said that woman has exhausted her money. He's been there for 12 years. He has finished all her money on medical doctor. They couldn't do anything because they want her to be proper. She has exhausted the money until she met Jesus and she touched the hem of the garment of Jesus. And the end was come. I speak to somebody today that you are afflicted with sickness and disease. Just to make sure that you are, as you are earning that big money, it's going to the, into the basket with gold. Today, in the name of Jesus, the healing power of God rests upon you. And you are healed in Jesus' name. You are healed in the name of Jesus. Set up can come in the form of barrenness. Barrenness to ensure a mother of a great child is frustrated to commit blasphemy, such that that woman will not fulfill destiny. Set up can be a plan for the kingdom of God to make somebody barren, to make sure the womb somebody is closed, to make sure the fallopian is blocked, because there's a great child that is coming, because there's a glorious child that is coming. Elizabeth is an example. In Luke chapter 1, verse 6 to 18, he was to born John the Baptist, where the Bible says in Matthew 11:11, that upon the men of the earth, that before the New Testament, nobody is greater than John the Baptist. John Baptist was a great man, but the devil didn't want the mother to conceive him. The womb was closed. But Elizabeth conceived and gave birth to John the Baptist. I pray for you. That barren woman, you are set up. It doesn't matter how they came from. To make sure you be barren. But you are not going to be barren. You will give back to John the Baptist. You will give back to Samuel. Your Samuel is coming. Your John the Baptist is coming. In the name of Jesus. Your Paul the Apostle is coming. Your Peter the Apostle is coming. In the name of Jesus. Your womb is open. Your womb is open. Your womb is open. In the name of Jesus. Blockade is removed. In the name of Jesus. Set up can come in form of demonic heavy debts with only one objective: to make sure that everything you have in life is disappeared. Set up can be form of every debt body, such that the objective of that debt is to make sure that everything you have in life is lost in repaying the loans. I pray for somebody here. They've told you they are going to take over your house because of the debts. The God that I serve miraculously will pay that debt for you in Jesus' name. For your faithfulness in tithe payment, in offering, in serving God, the God I serve will pay that debt in Jesus' name. And that house is not going to be sold in Jesus' name. The widow of Zarephath was an example. The husband is dead, remaining only the two children. And they came, they said, okay, the husband is there, the two children that is there, we will take them as a collateral for the loan. Since you cannot pay, and your husband cannot pay, but God arose. It was a setup for a lift-off. It was a setup for a financial breakthrough. And I prophesy, every setup of debt in your life, it will lead to your financial prosperity and abundance in Jesus' name. Setup can come in form of a curse, of embargo, of limitation. When there will need that somebody is going to be very great in large territories, it can set up can come of a spoken negative word to make sure the enlargement does not happen. Jabez was an example in 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 9 to 10. I want you to read that scripture when you get home, but I'm going to read this one for you. It's in 1 Chronicles chapter 4, 9 to 10. The word of God says, it says, Jabez was more honorable. The enemy knew the man was going to be very great than his brethren, and his mother called him a child of son. That was a setup by a spoken word to make him remain low in life. But Jabez setup turned to lift up. And everyone living under the conspiracy, under debt, you will turn to a lift up for you in Jesus' name. Brethren, lastly, setup can come in form of ganging up, conspiracy. Setup can come in form of conspiracy. Gang up, some days, gang up. Why? Just to steal and kill the fruit of your labor. The setup can come in from, they look at you when you are planting, when you are working, and just come when it is time of harvest, just to steal, to kill, and destroy. Isaac was an example in Genesis chapter 26. Isaac was an example in Genesis chapter 26, from verse 17 to 26. From 17 to 26. Isaac dug 4 wells, and all of them were taken for him. Isaac was an example. He dug 4 wells. 3 of them were taken from him. Why? Because they were taken for him so that it does not happen. They just want to steal the blessing. They want to kill the blessing. Every man that wants to use COVID-19 to steal your blessing, to kill your blessing, to steal your, destroy your blessing, the Lord will turn it around for your lifting in Jesus' name. The Lord will turn it around for your lifting in Jesus' name. So very quickly, before I go again, setup can come in form of organizational scheming to deny somebody of the disposition. Setup can come from a long-term sickness to ensure that someone that is not, that God does not fulfill God's ordained destiny. Setup can come, demonic setup, demonic scheming can come in form of attack to someone's health so that all the money in the person's hand can be used to pay to cure sicknesses that is not curable. Setup can come in form of barrenness, knowing that somebody is going to give birth to a great child of God. They close the womb so that the child does not come. Setup can come in form of heavy debts. Every debt. You can't even explain how this debt goes. Thank you, Jesus. There's a woman here. You cannot explain how this debt body just came. They were just coming. Before you realize the debt are so much that the banks are coming for you. I pray for you. Every demonic debt that arose from nowhere, they will disappear the way they come. And the debt will turn to a lifting for you in Jesus' name. Setup can come in form of embargo, a negative pronouncement to limit somebody's enlightenment. Setup can come from a conspiracy and gang up to steal what somebody has worked for. Why do people set up others? Why? Number one, is the work of flesh. Galatians chapter 5, verse 21. Galatians chapter 5, verse 21. Why do people set up others? Is the work of flesh. Galatians chapter 5, 19 to 21. Galatians chapter 5, 19 to 21. What? People, why? People set up other people because of the work of flesh. Envy, jealousy, strife, witchcraft can close the womb of somebody when they know it's going to have a great child. Manipulation. Witchcraft can inflict someone with tangled sickness and disease because they feel he has money so that that money should be used to spend curing sickness that is not curable. People can set up other people like in case of Daniel. It was hatred for Daniel because he's an expat, he's a foreigner. They don't know him and he's doing well. People do serve other people because of inordinate self-ambition. Remember, inordinate self-ambition, these are the works of flesh. Why do people serve other? Lack of understanding of God's plan and purpose for their life. Ephesians 4:7. People set up another because they see somebody going forward. They go to get to be like that person. They can't be like him. They set him up so that he will become insecurity that if he can be ahead of them because they don't know the plan of God for their lives. Hosea forces people up. My people pray for lack of knowledge. Hosea chapter 4 verse 6. See, my people pray for lack of knowledge. People are set up for lack of knowledge and understanding of the plan and purpose of God for their life. Ephesians 4:7 will say, God has a grace for everybody. And the grace of God for everybody is a measure of the gift of God in his life. Why we compare ourselves and start competing? That's why people set up. People set up because they don't know God. They don't know God allows certain for his own glory. People set up others because God allowed it for his name to be glorified in that life. Who are the candidates of set up? Number one, you are a great child of God. You are a great personality. You'll be envied. Whether you know it or you know it. The caliber of setup of every great child of God, every great personality, you'll be envied. Whether you know it or you don't know it. There are cases people who are great, they don't know they are great. An example is a man of Ghana. Man of Ghana was a great evangelist. He didn't know he was a great evangelist because he was in the tomb. But that does not stop them from still being set up, making match. Paul the Apostle, he didn't know he was supposed to be a great apostle for God. He was busy again killing Christians. Acts chapter 9, 1 to 6. He didn't know. Whether you know or you don't know that you're a great child of God, you will be envied. Number two, Whether you are receiving, whether you are receiving results, delivering results as a great person, or you are not delivering results, you will be settled. You need to understand. Whether you are delivering results or you are not delivering results, as a great child, as a great person, whether you know or don't know it, you will be set up. Gideon was a man of valor. He didn't even know it. In Judges 6:1, he didn't know it. Judges chapter 6, 11, he didn't know what he was a great child of God. He was not even known. But that doesn't stop him being set up. Eventually, at the end of the day, the same Gideon in Judges chapter 8, he was set up again by his idol of his father to bring him down. That's why you have to be very prayerful. Whether you are delivering results, when you are going to be envied, you are going to be set up. When you are a great achiever, a result-oriented personality, you will be set up. You are doing well in your office, get ready for set up. You are doing well in your occupation, get ready for your set up. You are doing well in ministry, get ready for yourself. They will set you up. And God will turn it for your lifting up. God will turn it for your lifting up in the name of Jesus. People with colorful and glorious destiny will be set up. You have a colorful, glorious destiny like Jabez. Oh, that was God told him that Jabez was more honored than his brethren in 1 Chronicles chapter 4, 9 to 10. When you have a glorious and colorful destiny, you will be set up like that. You are Jabez's personality. When God said in 1 Chronicles 4, 9 that Jabez was more honorable than his brethren, you will be set up. When you determine to fulfill the destiny in life, you will be set up. When all your plan is to be like the King Stephen. In Acts chapter 7, 15 to 19, that want to fulfill destiny, preach gospel. In Acts chapter 6, Deacon Stephen was ordained as a deacon. And the power of God, the Spirit of God was mighty upon his life. Because he wanted to fulfill destiny, the kingdom of darkness ganged up against him. He was set up. What are the tools of set up? Number one, remember what we are talking about, so that you will know when you see set up around you, it's common. This, you can begin with this. When you see set up, there's a lifting. So when you are a great child of God, you are being said, you know there's a lifting for you. When you're a child of God, you know that you are delayed conception, you know there's a setup for your lifting up. When you're a child of God, you have sicknesses that you don't know where it's coming from. You know it's your setup for your lifting. You know there's a set, that setup is for your lifting. So how do you, what are the tools they use? False accusation, denial of benefits or entitlement. The tool of setup, false accusation, denial of benefit and entitlement. That's what they did to Daniel. Incite you against decision makers or your bosses. The tool of setup, they will incite you against decision makers or your bosses. In the story of Daniel, he was incited against King Darius, who loved him so much. The tool of setup, draconian and unfavorable rule or policies. Tool of setup, draconian and unfavorable rule or policy. Tool of setup, delay. When there's a delay in your life, mean God is setting you up. You are a delay in your life. Delay conception, delay marriage, delay blessing. You know God is setting, lifting you up. There's a lifting up, and yet that's why there was a delay. When you notice there's a kind of cause, something hindering you, you are a candidate of lifting up. When you know you are, when there's a long terminal sickness, that is not something, there's a lifting up for you. I don't know that person that is sitting on the wheelchair. That person is lying down. You are lying down. You are lying down on a cushion, on a chair, on a settee in the living room now, and listen under the sound of my voice. I speak to you. That set up to make you see, to be in that time you are sitting there for years. Today is turned to a lifting up. And I speak in the name of Jesus. Arise and walk. Arise and walk. Arise and walk. Arise and walk. In the name of Jesus. What is lift up? Where we don't set up. Set up, what is a lifting up? A lift up means to raise someone from a lower to higher position. A set up is to lift somebody. A lift up means to raise somebody from a lower position to higher position. A lift up is to move somebody from a lower position to a higher position. 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 8. 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 8. The word of God says, he raised up the poor from the dust. He raised up the poor and lifted up the beggar from the donkey to set them among the princes and to make them inherit the throne of glory. For the pillars of the earth are the Lord. He has set the word upon them. You are set upon them. So a lifter is to raise somebody from a lower position to a greater position. So when people are, when God, when you are having delayed conception, it's because God didn't want to give ordinary child. He want to give a great evangelist. He want to give a great prophet. He want to give a world businessman. That's why there's a delay. When your business, your employment is delayed, it means God is making a managing director. It's making an employer of labor. When your finances is delayed, it means God is making you a mortal millionaire in change of business in the world. When there's a curse upon your life and you are a child of God, you know God is breaking the curse. It's making a blessing to generation. Who can God lift up? Who can lift up? God is the only one that can lift up. No man can lift you up. Psalm 75 verse 6. God is the only one that can lift a man up. And he said for promotion, Psalm 75 verse 6. He said for promotion come neither from east or the west, not from the west, not from the south, but from Almighty God. God is the one that can lift a man up. That was 1 Samuel 2, 8 saying. He said he raised all the poor from... I see God raising somebody up from nobody to somebody. I see God lifting somebody from nothing to somebody. I need somebody, God lifting somebody from nobody to a world acclaimed personality, a world acclaimed person. In the name of Jesus. Who are the people God lift up very quickly? Who are the people that God lift up? 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 A child of mercy. You want lifting? You want to be a child of mercy? You want a lift up, you must be a product of mercy. You must be somebody that pray for mercy, that plead for mercy all the time. Exodus chapter 3 verse 19. And he said, I will make all my goodness pass before thee, Moses. I will proclaim the name of the Lord before thee. I will be gracious to whom I will be gracious to. I will show mercy whom I will show mercy unto. Whatever is going to make you known from nobody to somebody is mercy. What can raise a beggar from the dunghill and a poor man from the dust? It can only be mercy of God. And make them to see with princes and kings. It can only be mercy of God. What can make an adulterer child, a product of adultery, to become the king in Israel? It can only be mercy of God. Who can God lift up? You must be a child of mercy, a product of mercy. You can't do it on your own. By strength shall no man prevail. First Samuel 22:9 said, First Samuel chapter 5, he said, by strength shall no man prevail. Nobody can move from nobody to somebody. Where there are cabals, where there are principalities, where there are power. But when God lifts a man, cabal will put aside. When God lifts a man, principality will put down. When God lifts a man, nobody stand on his way. He crosses them. I pray for somebody today. God will lift you from nobody to somebody and will set aside the cabals, the principality, the occult member in the name of Jesus. Who are the people that God can lift up? A servant of God. Listen, don't get me wrong. I'm not talking about a pastor, a minister of God. No. A servant of God is somebody that serves God. God said in Psalm 89 verse 20. Psalm 89 verse 20. Say, I found David my servant. God is looking for servant to lift up. He's not looking for kings to lift up. God is looking for servant to lift up. So people will stand as a servant to him. Say, I found David my servant with my holy Lord. Am I anointed him? God is looking for humble people to lift up. The word servant there to me means humble. God is looking for humble people to be lifted up. He's not looking for pride people. Who are the people that God will lift up? People with act of service. So winning. People with act of service. He said again to David in Acts chapter 13, verse 22. He said, when he has removed himself, he raised up unto David to be their king, to whom also he gave testimony and said, I have found David my servant, the son of Jesse, a man after my heart, which shall fulfill all my will. A man that act of service for God. Who can God lift up? You want God to lift you up? You want God to lift you from the setup? Then you must have out of God. If they are setting you up in your office, all you need to plead for mercy. If you are setting up in any organization, anywhere you find it, all you need to plead is for mercy. If you are setting up any location, anywhere, all you need to do is to be a servant of God, to serve God. If they are setting you anywhere, all you need to do is to have an act to serve God, the act of service. You see, all those schema will be chased away. They will be put down before you. You want to be lifted up inside the setup. You are a woman believing God for the fruit of womb. Have the heart to serve God. You are a woman believing God for the Food for womb. Have the heart to serve God. Even if they block your womb, the one that has power over everybody will remove the blockage. You have been having terminal sickness, terminal disease for years. In that situation, plead for mercy. In that situation, be a servant of God. In that situation, have the heart to serve God. Who are the people that God will lift up inside the setup? You are set up, God will lift you up only if you have a love of righteousness. You are being set up and you are about to be set up. God will lift you up if there is a love of righteousness. Hebrews chapter 1, verse 9. Hebrews chapter 1, verse 9. It said, thou hast loved righteousness and hated iniquity. Therefore, God, even thy God, anointed with all of gladness about thy fellow. God have anointed with about it. So if you love righteousness, you hate that sin. If you love righteousness and you hate sin, God will lift you up from the setup. David was set up by his brothers. Joseph was set up by his brothers. But in that, because he loved righteousness, because he hates sin, because Joseph refused to sleep with the Potiphar's wife, God lifted him up. As you make up your mind to love righteousness, as you make up your mind to love righteousness, as you make up your mind to love righteousness, as you make your mind to hate sin, to say no to sin, God will lift you up inside the setup, inside the gather up. Lord will lift up. In the name of Jesus, set up. People that set you up are supposed to be your stepping stone to higher ground. Who can God lift up? Someone that will do the will of God. Someone that will do the will of God. Who will God lift up inside the setup? When you are set up, what we make God will decide whether God will lift you up or not is that, are you doing the will of God or supporting the will of God? There was a woman in the Bible, they call her Rahab. She was a prostitute. In Joshua chapter 2, verse 1, Rahab was a prostitute. Nobody knew her. He was a prostitute. But when Joshua sent a spy to the land of Jericho to go and spy the land, Rahab accommodated the two spies and told them, I will hide you, and he did it. When the king Jericho sent people to her house, give me the spy, he said, no, they are not dead. And the same Rahab become the great grandfather of David. The same Ahab became the great grandfather of David. The same Ahab became the great grandfather of David. All because of she did the will of God. She supported the will of God. She supported the will of God to move the people to possess their possession in the land of Canaan. So I pray for you, as many people that is supporting the will of God, as many people that is doing the will of God, God will lift you up in the name of Jesus. In my closing, just let me recap that one. Who can God lift up? When you are inside a lift up, God will lift you up if you plead for mercy. If you are inside a lift up, who are the God that God, how sure God will lift you up? If you are a servant of God, you are serving God. You are the act of service. Inside that lift setup, God will lift you up. Who is the one person that God will lift up in the midst of setup? The lover of righteousness. In this season, the people that God will lift up in this coronavirus are those who are product of mercy. In this season, where coronavirus is ravaging the world, the people that will be lifted up in this season are those people who know they are product of mercy. Are those people who are servant of God. Are those people who are having the act of service? Are those people who love righteousness? Are those people who will do the will of God? In this season of COVID-19, if you love God and love righteousness, you'll be lifted up inside COVID-19 setup. If you love God in this season, inside God, in that COVID-19, if you believe in mercy, you plead mercy, you'll be lifted up. In this season of COVID-19 setup, if you are a lover of you hate sin, God will lift you up. Why does God allow setup? Why does God allow? That's why we're close. God allows setup to prove his original majesty. God, why did God allow setup? To prove that his original majesty. God allows setup to prove that his original majesty. That is the one that all power in heaven and earth belong to him. Matthew 28:19-20. Matthew 28:19. To prove that in all power in heaven and earth belong to him is an original majesty. He can do whatever he likes. He can do what he pleases. No man can stop him. No man can hinder him. He's an original majesty. Amen. Why does God allow Satan to prove his sovereignty that all power belongs to him? Psalm 115:3. Our God is in heaven, does as he pleases. Psalm 135:6. The Lord does whatever he pleases in heaven and earth, in the seas and on earth. So God to prove his sovereignty. That's why he allows Satan. To say, you can't put that level and leave that. God, why does God allow set up by human being, so that he can turn your mess to message. God allows spectrum so that he can turn the mess who are put you a message. God is turning somebody mess to message. In the name of Jesus, God is turning somebody mess to message. In the name of Jesus, God is turning somebody mess to message. The message they put you, they are God is turning to me. I like you to kind of go. Say, my father, this COVID-19 mess, turn it to a message for me. My father, my savior, this COVID-19 mess that messed up my business, that messed up my career, turn to a message. A message, oh Lord. Turn to a message that will be giving testimony to all over the world. Turn my mess to testimony of mess. Turn my mess to testimony. Turn our business mess, our career mess, our ministry mess to a testimony to all over the world to say God is indeed, he is very good to us. In the name of Jesus. Why God allows setup for lift up? Because God can turn story to glory. God wants to turn story to glory. You are going to cry to God. In the book of Genesis chapter 45 verse 7, God turned the story of Joseph. God turned the story of Joseph, envy, jealousy, household wickedness, malicious attack, conspiracy, false accusation, turned into a glory to become a prime minister in the land of Egypt. Genesis chapter 45 verse 7. I want to cry to God. Say, my father, turn my false accusation, turn envy situation, turn jealousy in my life, turn them to glory, take me to higher ground in Jesus' name. Say, my father, my savior, turn all false accusation against me, turn envy against me, turn all lies against me, turn all jealousy against me, turn them to glory, and take me to higher ground. Tell them to my glory, my business glory, my ministerial glory, my career glory, in the name of Jesus. Shakata Lava. Let us say good day. Why does God allow setup? I say God allows setup to turn your business mess, to turn your career mess to a testimony and message for the whole world to know. Libra Sudada. Why does God allow setup to turn your story of hatred, of shame, to glory? Why does God allow setup? God wants to use the foolish thing to confirm the wise. Who can believe an Arnold can be a great grandmother of David? Who can believe that Arnold can be a great grandmother of David and become the same Arnold Rahab, become the lineage of the Lord Jesus Christ? I like you to cry to God. Say, my father, my savior, turn my setup to a lifting of higher glory. In the name of Jesus, turn my setup to a lifting of higher glory. In the name of Jesus, turn my setup into higher glory. In Jesus' name, turn my setup in business, in ministry, into career, to higher glory of a lifting up, of a promotion, of greatness, of abundance. In the name of Jesus, Latoria Katusede. I don't know as I close. There's a young man here. When I was praying this morning, the Lord showed me a young man that came from village. He came from village, or you went to Africa, you left Africa, you went up, you came with one cloth. God told me he came with one cloth and share. The Lord said, I tell you, he's turning your story to glory. You came with one cloth and one share. You'll be a lender to nation. You'll be a blessing to nation. In the name of Jesus. You left Uganda, you left Africa to another nation with a one shirt, with no clothes. God is turning your story around. He's turning your story around to glory. He's turning your story around to glory. Say, my father, my savior, turn my story to glory. Turn around my story to glory. My story to glory. Turn my setup to lift up of glory. In the name of Jesus, share the zebra too. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. I don't want to close this service without giving those people who have not surrendered your life to Jesus an opportunity. It's an opportunity. I don't want to, because all what we have been talking about is for the children of God. You want us to set up, to talk, to lift it up. It means you must be a child of God and a child of mercy. You must be a child of God, a child of mercy. You must be a servant of God. You must love righteousness and hate iniquity. You must love righteousness and hate iniquity. You must be a child of mercy. You must love God. You must be ready to do the will of God. You can only do that if you are a child of God. You are here this afternoon, you have not surrendered your life to Jesus Christ. I'd like to give you the opportunity. I say this simple word. I say, Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I boldly declare I am born again. I'm washed by the, I'm saved, I'm born again in the name of Jesus Christ. I am saved and washed by the blood of Jesus. And by the blood of Jesus, I am justified. I'm sanctified. From today, I am saved. No more than the body of sin. In Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. There's some people that I want to pray for quickly. You are standing, you are under the sound of my voice.
Amen.
You are not, your ways are not right with God. You are living in sin. You are a born-again Christian. But you live in sin. You love iniquity. I want to pray with you that God deliver from the power of sin so that you can be, so that that setup can turn to your lifting up. Lift up and say, my father, I want to pray for all your sons and daughters that they are currently living in sin. Father, please have mercy on them. The power of sin, lose your grip over them in Jesus' name. The power of sin, lose your grip over them in Jesus' name. From today, you are saved. I say you are born again in the name of Jesus. Power of sin is destroyed over your life in the name of Jesus. So on this day, you begin a shining star for God in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, we just want to thank you for those answered prayer. Father, accept our offering. This is for the gift of your gospel. In the name of Jesus. For those who are paid the tenth of their honey, open the windows of heaven and bless them. For those who are paid their tenth of honey, bless them mightily. Let them not have any know the better yesterday in the name of Jesus. Let them only ask the cost to the tenth of their honey. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. I want to thank you so much for being part of this telecast today. I'm sure I need your testimony. Please share your testimony. God has done great things today. There's a setup for someone that's going to be lifted up in Jesus' name. So if you are yes, today, I'd like you to go to our social media page, go to our YouTube channel, RCC Jesus and Kampala, RCC Jesus and Kampala, subscribe to our channel, like our channel, and share our channel. Go to our Facebook, RCC Jesus on Facebook, RCC Jesus on YouTube Facebook, follow our channel, our Facebook page, like our Facebook page, share our page, and comment our page. We also have an Instagram page. RCC Jesus on Instagram page. Those are my Instagram. So go to our Instagram page too. Share this testimony with us. And the Lord will bless you. Lord will keep you and cause His face to shine upon you. Tomorrow is another day. It's another day. Part 3, let the fire fall. Tomorrow is another day. Let the fire is the time of another prayer. This month, this year, we will possess our position. This month, this year, we will possess our position. In the name of Jesus. I want to thank God for your life. Father, I want to thank you for your children that have been part of this blessing today. Father, I thank you for the move of your power. I thank you for your healings. I thank you for your deliverance. I thank you for your word of knowledge. Lord, I pray today for everything you have done, let it be established. Let it be permanent in the name of Jesus. Everything you have done, cover the blood of Jesus. I soak with the blood of Jesus. Everything you have done, I cover with the blood of Jesus. I soak them with the blood of Jesus. Every shiara, you are blessed. You are lifted. Every shiara, you are blessed and you lifted. Every commenters, you want to have commented, you are blessed and lifted up. Every word, oh Lord, that have lied the page, you are blessed and you have lifted up. In the name of Jesus, I decree to you, your blessing has come with blood, Jesus. Your blessing has come with blood, Jesus. In the name of Jesus, you are testifying. I am testifying. You are testifying. I am testifying. Before tomorrow, we will share our testimony. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Till I see you tomorrow, Lord bless you. Lord keep you. And God's way to shine upon you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.